So, hey everyone. I know I haven't done anything for a while. I've been kind of busy, well, for a week or so. But I wanted to try and get another part up of this lion and get onto that. So, I thought I would do a bit of this. I'll probably edit it tomorrow just because it's getting late now. And I'll be considering bed soon. But yeah, I just wanted to record another part of this so that I can get it edited tomorrow and uploading. And then, depending, we'll see if I upload it tonight or edit it tonight, but probably won't. But yeah, I thought I'd get that done and then I can get another part up for you all. Probably where I'll continue is with this nose bit for now, because that was where we were working on last time. And I'll just continue with working out where the shading's going to go with the nose and the lion and go from there. So it'll probably be a lot of the same colours as last time. Yeah, well, as usual, refresher of the colours we're using is, well, Prismacolor Premier. We're using black PC935. Sepia PC948, Tuscan Red PC937, Burnt Ochre PC943, Mineral Orange PC1033, Sand PC940, and the colours that we use at times but not all the times, Cream PC914 and White PC938. So as I said, I'll get going, I'll continue with this part. I'll probably work in some of the shadows and work out where I'm going to take those highlights first, and then we'll continue from there. Yes. So I'm going to come in with our Tuscan Red first, because we're not so much focusing on the sepia for these parts, because we don't want the lion's nose to be too dark. This part of the lion's nose to be too dark. So I'm going to work out roughly where I want my sepia to go and bring that in, continuing from where we left off with the sepia and that last time. I'm just bringing in light at first so that I can work out roughly where I go, because I find trying to erase Prismacolors, it doesn't always work out, so better to be safe than sorry and just do a light coating first, because then even if you can't get the full colour erased, at least you can get some of the colour erased. What I'm doing, I'm just bringing it up here a bit. We're just looking at where we continued, because it was around here where we continued with our burnt ochre, I think it was. So I sort of don't want to overlap that layer too much, because we've got the light going up here like this, so. Working out if I continue a bit just up here with the Tuscan Red, I think I will. And here's sort of a mix of our Tuscan Red and Mineral Orange and Burnt Ochre and that, so I'm gonna bring the Tuscan Red up through here. any circles, I'd just go over them. Some of the lines again. Part of the shading up here more later on. Start bringing this down here. We won't worry about putting the black in and deepening it and that yet, but this part will be part of our shadows again down there. Same for this part along here. So now we're going to go in and deepen that up. In those spots, I'm not going to worry about the outside parts where we'll have the black in it just yet. I am leaving slight areas where it's not so dark, just so that makes it easier for blending the other colours in. Thank you. in this spot here, where it's got these parts that'll be sort of deeper in that spot, so we'll need to bring in some of our darker colours in there. So that's why I decided to colour all down the bottom and have that there ready. Same for these parts up where I'm colouring now. We need some of our deeper colours in it. This part up here will need deeper colours too, but I'll have to work that out as I go. Hope you've all been well anyway. Also, I find too, best not to rush going around small spaces, or you do go over the lines more, which I have found. I have done before when I've been trying to rush something or rush colouring one part in or something. So I find best to take it slow, then you don't go over the lines quite as much. It also helps when you have a sharpened pencil that's properly sharpened, but I'm trying to not sharpen the Prismacolors all the time because I want them to last as long as possible before I have to buy new ones or before I have to buy replacements for the colours I've got. Because, as said before, they're kind of expensive here. Cheaper than polychromos, but still very expensive. Probably won't have quite so much of the yucky colours, I'm not sure, but I've worked that out yet. But we'll bring that down to connect with this part. Yeah, we did add the black in. Well, with the light colour anyway, just because I didn't have the pencil properly sharpened at that time, so same for the other lines in the small spaces. Doesn't always pay to not sharpen your pencil all the time, but yeah. Come back to those parts I was thinking of. I'll come back to that bit once I've got more of an idea. So now what we're going to do is go in with our might do our black / sepia first. This side, we want to bring this. Oops, that's the sepia, not the black. We'll bring the black up here. And then we want to bring our sepia up in here. Oh, Tuscan Red, sorry. Tired. Into these parts a bit as well. Trying not to go inside the lines, but you can't always avoid it, unfortunately. I'm just going to colour over that one too to make it easier. Same for this one, to make it easier to bring the colours up in there, like I want. Tuscan Red back in, sorry. Sepia Red. It's not Sepia Red here. We're going to bring in a sepia after we just blend a bit more red into the black. To sort of even out that blending. Trying not to go over the line. Now what we're going to do, we're going to go in with our sepia. We're going to not worry about the sepia down in this part, because this is sort of, as you'll remember, we sort of had more of the oranges down here, so we don't want so much sepia in above this line here, so we want to bring it in more towards the top here, just to blend in that black a bit more. Thank you. It's gonna have to stay that way. We'll have to do that. I'll just colour over that one and add that. Leave that, but that. Fix that mistake. Even I make mistakes sometimes. And it annoys me, but that's life. Everyone makes mistakes, I guess. Now we're just gonna bring this bit in here because we don't wanna sort of bring those shadows down there. So that's our sepia. Now we're gonna go back in with our Tuscan red again and color over those colors again. To blend them all in. Then put our sharpener down. We're going to go in with that burnt ochre, and I think I'll sharpen that before doing these little spaces again. And we go over all the colours with the burnt ochre. But we don't do the burnt ochre on this side. This side goes straight to the orange, if I remember correctly. So, we're just doing this side with the burnt ochre. Actually, I might just stop it there for a minute and then I'll start it again just because we're up to 23 minutes and the battery will cut out soon, and then I'll continue it in a minute. So yeah, be back in a minute. So I'm back. We're just going to continue with our burnt ochre and we'll continue on this side here. We're just colouring over the Tuscan red as well, but trying not to go over this line, which has kind of been faded out from accidentally going over it with the Tuscan red when we're doing that. So trying not to go over it this time. And we're just bringing these shadows up into the Tuscan reds. Into the black with the burnt ochre, just into the reds and the sepia a bit, just to bring that colour into them. And then we're going to come back down here. Pause. we're going to bring the burnt ochre down into these reds, but we're not going to take it down over where you got your lighter red, just because that'll be orange there. So we still want that colour in here. Come in just with some light shadows in here to allow you to bring the colour, blend the other colours in it easier. So just very light burnt ochre shadows above where you got the darker colours. You will notice there's not quite so much burnt ochre showing in this one, but that's because that's how I kind of wanted it, so yes. Next, just clean that off because we've been using it for another book, so it's got a bit of browns and stuff on it. We're going to come in next with our mineral orange, and this time we're sort of bringing in our mineral orange on this side over all the reds and that. But we sort of want to bring it out a bit more on this side, and we're going to take it around the other side over the burnt ochres too, so it's going to loop around like this, sort of shadowing the areas where it's meant to be. And yet again, I'm going over the small areas by accident. Sometimes I'm a bit of a perfectionist, so I don't like going over the lines. But can't help it, I guess. I'm just going to sharpen this. Even though it's not really down to being blunt yet, it's just going to make it easier. So I feel like I'm wasting so much of the pencil when I sharpen it before it's properly blunt. I don't know if anyone else feels that way. It's the only way to kind of prevent going over the lines in some ways. Lucky we're going to colour in those areas again, and that'll help cover it up a bit. Lucky we're not leaving them white. I do find too, you do tend to make more mistakes when tired, but I just really wanted to get this video out because I don't know if I'll get to, oh, this video recorded, because I don't know if I'll have time to record and edit both tomorrow, because I have a lot I need to do. Yeah, went over the lines again. Yeah, did it again in the same spot. I'll probably cut it out after we do this part of the nose. I was thinking of going longer, but I'm obviously tired and making mistakes, which is not good. Thank you. think I'm just gonna take a minute just to wake myself up a bit, and then I'll come back and do the sand and do the colours in the nose part, just because, I'll continue this part later on up here, but this was just because it's out of the screen, I'm sort of not continuing with that part at the moment. But so I'll be back in a minute and do that. I just want to get up and walk around a bit, wake up a bit, so that I'm sort of not making quite so many mistakes in my eyes anyway. So I'll be back. So I'm back. I accidentally moved that in a bit when I moved out of my chair before. But, so I'm going to continue here. I think I just added in light shades into these parts before I went. Just adding in a little more just to be safe with our mineral orange. Want to try and make it look as natural as possible with the way blending comes in. And then what we're going to do, we're going to go in with our sand. I probably don't think I'll use the cream or white in this part. I will see, I may use some cream and white. I'm just going to work that out as I go. So I need to just sharpen that a little more too, just so that it goes into the gaps easier. And we're just going to do that over every colour again with the sand, just to bring it in a bit more. I'm just going around the edges at the moment because I may bring some cream in. I'm not totally sure. So I'm just leaving it at the minute in case I do decide I want to bring it in, because you can't bring it in once you've sort of coloured over that area already. Particularly if it's a darker colour, it just doesn't work. At least that's what I've found. Here first, and then I'm going to go into the other colours now. Well, for this side anyway, I'll go into the other colours. And as you'll probably notice, why I go darker to lighter is because I find that allows you to blend the colours in better and give you a more gradual variation of the colours, rather than just having one blocky black line when you use the darker colours last. But that's just for me. Others might not have that issue, but it's just what I find works for me, so it's what I do. You just sort of have to do what works for you. What works for someone else might not work for you. You know what? Just adding our sand in these parts. Here, bring it down into these parts. And blending it into those colours. Just going back up through all the parts that I didn't blend it into before. You can do about it. I went into the Tuscan Red and I accidentally had some red left on the pencil that I got into the light a bit. But I went over and managed to blend that in a bit. So now I'm just adding in a lighter layer here because I am going to go in with some cream and that. So we want to go in with our cream. And you probably won't worry about taking this over every colour. Just want to take it over the sand mostly, just to blend the two in together. As you notice, I am finding it hard to keep from going inside the lines, but being tired doesn't help with that, but also trying to colour in little spaces, it can sometimes be quite tricky, and that can sometimes cause you to go inside other lines when you don't need to. Now I'm just going to go in with our white in this final little bit in here just to add in. So as you'll see, it's on the similar side as this part, so the light part is continuing on the same side, so where you see the light shining from. So, and I think I've gone over a heap of little spotty areas there, but not much you can do about it. Now what we're going to do, we're going to use the same colours we used last time for these little nose bits, but we're going to bring them up into these parts now. So what we're going to do, I think we used Sepia, our Tuscan Red and our Burnt Ochre last time for those parts. So you can use the sepia first, and as usual you follow where the light sources are coming from or shining from. So we sort of want this side, sort of the light bit is towards the top area in it. Still working out whether I have the light source coming up from this corner up where I'm holding the pencil from there up that way, or whether I'm having it coming from more that way down, but I'm thinking I'll probably have it coming this way up that way. So the way where my fingertips are, that'll probably be the top where the light source is coming from. I'm just thinking because we've sort of gone a lot more darker shadows over this side, so it probably makes more sense that it's coming from the corner up because a lot more of the lighter areas are on this side of the line. At least that's my thoughts at the moment. So yeah, we'll just continue here. Still using our sepia. If I have gone over with white by accident in the lighter spot, that'll probably make it lighter, which probably isn't a bad thing, being as it is a lighter area, but we'll just see what happens with it, as to if that is the case or not when we get to that part. It sort of looks like it, but we have to wait and see. Actually, I just realised a lot of the light, I did the light so it was coming down. So it may be coming down and reflecting that way. Ugh, I still have to work this out because I just realised where I was doing the shadows is underneath, so it's like the light is coming from there down. Sorry, just thinking. I tend to do that when I'm thinking. So yeah, the light source is probably coming from there down and reflecting down. More so. Yeah, and there'd be more light sort of on this side if this side is more sort of in shadow. I think that's just how I'm going to do it. It gets confusing sometimes when plans keep changing and then you realise before you continue too far that... Oh, hang on, I was doing the light source kind of this way with these parts, so it kind of needs to go this way instead. Looks like I did go over with white in some of those spots because some are coming out a bit lighter than others. Yeah, they are, so they do have some white over them. I hope you're enjoying this anyway and this is helping. And you're enjoying doing it. Also, why I'm sticking to 8 colours with this one is because sometimes I like to have a bit of a challenge and just see what I can do with 8 colours only, with a certain number of colours only, because sometimes it can be quite surprising what you can do when you think about it with a limited number of colours. Sometimes you get a really nice surprise, sometimes it doesn't work out. It all sort of varies. But it's still a good challenge as it shows you that you can do images with limited colours. So I used to use every single colour, nearly every single colour in the tray in the images. And that kind of I guess got boring with the time, so I decided to start trying to do some images with limited colours. As you'll see, I've changed direction slightly again just because of the way the bits are sitting with the lines for Millie's got them going two different directions, so they're going like that on the nose. So you sort of get the dimension of the nose as it goes up. So I'm swapping depending on which way the pieces are going, because of and trying to follow the light source to keep the bit where it's supposed to be light. I just realised too, I forgot to put a bit of the shading in these parts here. So we're doing a bit of nose now too. We're just going to do the same colours in those bits as we're doing for these little pieces on the nose. So it's the sepia, the Tuscan red and the burnt ochre. So yes, now we're going to go in with our Tuscan Red, and I'll probably just do this quietly because you saw me explain this in the last video. As usual, just going over every colour. Pencil on your paper, normally you end up with the pencil lines smudged over things. Now it's only 9 o'clock and I'm ready for bed. I'm only 31, I must be getting old if I'm starting to go to bed fairly early. We'll see how this goes though. It may mean I have a bit of time to start editing the video to get it uploading overnight. We'll see. Or I may not. But just see how things go. I'm still trying to work out schedules to be able to do everything I want to do with this stuff and keeping everyday stuff done and chores and sort of don't have a job right now because, well, I haven't had one for 4 or 5 years because of my ankle issues and because I lost work when my previous job was taken over by another company, and so I'm sort of thinking, well, at a friend's suggestion and my mum's suggestion, maybe I'll start trying to work in all my crafty stuff during, like, daytime hours, so have set days for different things, because I do jewelry making. I'm also starting to make like some mermaid accessories or doing some sewing stuff, doing my coloring videos. I went over into the white there. Well, you can't really tell, and all of that, so trying to set aside working day hours for different things that I'm needing to do with my crafty stuff. So, and then do the chores and stuff for weekends and outside hours. But I'll see how things go, and I'm sure I'll work it out eventually and get it all sorted eventually. Just not enough hours in the day to do everything, as you probably all know. Whoops, sorry, I just moved the thing out again. I've got pencil lines on things. Because I bumped it with my chair. Apologies. There we go. I'm just going to stop the camera there briefly because swap the battery just before it dies, and I'll come back and do the burnt ochre, and I might continue with some other bits in this. I'll work it out, and yeah, I'll see you soon. Bye. So I'm back. I'm hoping the lighting hasn't changed too much on there since I swapped it. But yeah, so we're going to go in with our burnt ochre now, and we're just going to finish off those little pieces, and as usual you go over every colour. Not going to be able to blend in the lines so much with these ones just because it's such a small space. And we're fitting in three colours into that small teeny space. probably not to go over the lines too much either into those light areas. The nose done, that bit of the nose done, as you'll see. I'm just working out where I'll go to next. If I do more on this part, I'm not sure if I'll continue this or if I just leave it there. I might just continue a little bit more for some parts and then I'll probably head off soon. And we don't want black, we want sepia to start with. Sorry, I was just getting my pencils. So, just working out where I want to go to next. So, probably continue with some of the eye bits, I'm thinking. What I'll do, I'll do the Tuscan Red and Black later. But I'm going to continue with this side of the eye, and we're just going to bring our sepia up like this, darken it up in those spots where needed, and have that lighter area. Just yet again following the light source. So, bringing these up like this, following the light source. The eyes, I probably will have a look how to draw. Well, I've got an idea how to draw eyes, but I just want to refresh my memory, so I'm going to go and have a look online, because I want to do some realistic-ish looking lion eyes in there if I can. So I'm going to leave the eyes for now, just because I want to have a look and again and just refresh my memory and do that. So here we're just bringing our sepia in where our main shadows will go. I'm sort of leaving, because this part here is the underneath skin part, like the rest. It's sort of where the in-between parts, where the patterns are, go. So I'm kind of leaving that for now, and I'm sort of doing that as I go. In some, well, yeah, I am kind of doing it as I go, but I'll probably keep going with the Tuscan Red and the black in those spots, but I'm not totally sure. I may add some other colours, I don't know yet. That's why I'm kind of leaving that area for now. So yeah, just coming in here with a sepia. Need to deepen up some of these areas just a little more. So much pencil off as we do it. So I used to get annoyed because I kept having to go over and redo the areas I'd already done because it kept rubbing off on my hand. And I find doing it this way, it doesn't rub off quite as much colour as it does when you've just got your bare hand on there. Lucky that bit's probably the darker areas anyway, so it doesn't matter that much. Is bringing our shadows in here. We just continue on this eye bit for now, just because we're getting lower on time. I have to check how much time I've got left on the SIM card after this one ends. So I'm not quite sure how much. I think it was 40 minutes or something, but I'm not sure. So I'll need to check once this one's done. Once I've recorded this bit, here is if I can continue or not. So we're now going in with our Tuscan Red. Just leave out a little bit of light shading around there to make it easier to bring in our next colours. I'm going to bring that up here. These small areas, we won't fit as many colours as some of the other areas. A little larger. So we may not fit sand in some of the smaller areas, we'll just have to see sand colour or mineral orange or any of that. We'll have to have a look as we go and see if we fit them in or not. Thank you. also why I'm not repeating the same sides quietly with so much with this video right now, why they're sort of going different sides in different videos. It's just because of the fact that this piece is very detailed, and so it takes a long time to do. So yes, that's our Tuscan Red done. Now we're going to go in with our burnt ochre. Just add that in over all the colours like usual. Like usual, when we start shading, adding in our black and that, we'll add in our double shades of these colours again. Yeah, some of these little ones will probably finish with the burnt orange. Mineral orange. My brain needs to start working. I'm just going to pause it there for a minute, check how much time I've got left so I've got a rough idea, and then I'll come back and continue finishing just this bit around the eye, and then we'll probably leave it. Then I'll say I'll leave it there for the night. So I'll be back shortly. So I'm back. We're gonna go in now with our mineral orange, and some areas this will be the finishing colour. Other areas we're gonna try and attempt to add in the sand colour as well to finish it off. So some of these smaller areas this will finish the colours in those areas till we add the shadows, which I'll have to go and add them in too after we've done these colours. As you'll notice, we're just working on getting that nice graduation between the colours again. Colored over anyway. The reason why I don't attempt to rub out those little spots where I go over the lines is because then sometimes it rubs out all the other color and then I can't get the color to stick properly to the page again. So I tend to avoid rubbing out as much as possible in case that does occur. Now we're going to go in with our sand. And we're still going to colour that over even the areas that have the finished with the mineral orange, just to keep it all looking even and nice. Thank you. we're going to do. We're going to add in our black. And I may not go over all the colours again. We shall see. I'll work it out as I go. But we're just going to do our outlines with our black where it needs to be. It should be darker. We will blend in some of the other colours again. Because we're going to bring our sepia in a bit to blend it in. Come in with our sepia. Probably will go over it with the Tuscan Red and stuff as well again, just to bring in that red depth to it again. Come in again with our Tuscan Red. Colour that over all the colours. And we're doing that over all the colours. Again. It is our burnt ochre we come in with again. Just sort of need to blend that in with the red. It doesn't need to go over every bit of the black and that as well this time. Doesn't need to. And we're going to go in with our mineral orange. Some of these pieces I'm leaving just a little piece at the edge for the sand to go in. But some parts have had colour go over them where the sand was, by the looks of it, but do the best you can. Just because these are smaller, it's harder to fit a lot more colours in, and I'm fitting a lot of colours into these small spaces. And I'm not colouring over the black with the mineral orange. I'm not trying to anyway. I'm more just going over the reds and stuff. And now we're going to go in with our sand. And just go over those colours to the red. We're not going to go over the black with the sand either. I think quickly what I'm going to do, I'm going to come in with the Tuscan Red and the black up into these parts here. Just to bring out those colours a bit. Time available on the SD card. Going through every space yet because I'm sort of still working things out as I go as to what I'll do with the shadows or whatnot. But I kind of want some depth and some dark colours in around these eyes. Five minutes left. If this cuts out, I'll probably just finish this little piece anyway. Hopefully it won't cut out, but we just have to wait and see if I get it done in time or not. But as usual, it's just the Tuscan Red, the black, and then Tuscan Red again on top of the black, in case it does cut out. Thank you. Now we're going to go in with our black. I'm thinking I'm not going to do the black all the way through this, just where you see the shadows bits, that's going to be the black. Going down into the Tuscan Red, just providing our depth. And then the Tuscan Red will probably go into some other colours in the other spots, I'm not sure yet. We'll work that out, but right now I don't want the black all the way through this area. I kind of want the black where really where the shadows are around the eyes. Just really bringing that depth into the image. We are going to bring it down around these areas though. Just because our shadows are meant to be in those spots. Now we're going to go in with our Tuscan Red again. We've got a couple of minutes left here. If it does cut out, I'm sorry. There's kind of not much I can do about it if the SD card does run out. And we're just bringing the red partially up right now just because I'm not sure if I'm going to add some other colours in those spots or just leave the red in those spots or what. I'm still working that bit out because I don't want it all black around these parts where the fans are, where the eyes. I kind of want it graduating into them as I've done here. Really sort of bringing that depth and shadow in around the eyes. That's what we really want here. Bring this down here. Need to bring some shadows up into here. Recommend rushing, but I'm trying to finish this part before the video ends. So yeah, I'm going to look up the eyes and look at drawing a real eye in this part. I'll probably continue further with the rest next time. But yeah, I hope you like this and I'll see you later.